from Thunder Bay, reach for the top championship finals. This is Tim Saddle, John Ma, Dave Harrison, Jonathan Wilson from Fort William Collegiate Institute. This is Danny Piccolo, John Momot, Paul Ross, Mark Tilbury from St. Patrick High School. Today, these two teams meet in game two of a two-game total point championship final of Reach for the Top to decide the Thunder Bay champion. Your host and guest quizmaster, Barry Third.
Thank you very much once again, Bob McDonald. Barry Third standing in for Ron Bottas in this, the championship final on this season's Reach for the Top. You will have noticed our scoreboard registering a 105-point lead for St. Pat's High over Fort William Collegiate. That, of course, is the result of last week's game, the first in this two-game total point series to determine our final champion here on Reach for the Top this year. A bit of a hole for FWCI to start with, but we're sure you're going to make that up. We're going to get right to the action in just a moment, but before we do, we would like to introduce to you our judge here on Reach for the Top. Please welcome Nora Ellis. Nora, thanks for being with us again. Good luck to all our players. Stand by your buzzers. Once again, we will open with general questions as we always do. Here is the first one. Over what two areas of the Earth's surface are the holes in the ozone layer? Paul.
North and South Pole.
Good for 10 points. What is the Spanish word for a short nap? John.
A siesta.
That's good for 10 as well. In what European city would I find Nelson's Column? John.
London.
Good for 10 there as well. And what 26-mile road racing event was launched? Tim.
A marathon.
I'll finish it for St. Pat's. Was launched in 1970 and has been run annually ever since through John.
The Boston Marathon?
No, it's the New York Marathon we were looking for there. Open question for you players. We're 30 points now on mountains. This is not a mere geography question. These are mountains with a difference. This mountain was regarded by the ancient Greeks as the home of Apollo and John.
Olympus.
I'll finish it for Fort William Collegiate and the Muses, and therefore the mountain of poetic inspiration. FWCI, the mountain is Helicon. This mountain in present-day Turkey is supposedly where, John?
Mount Ararat.
Ararat is correct. Back to mythology, this real mountain was the mythical home of the greater Dave.
Olympus.
Olympus, good for 10 points there. Open question worth 30 points now on math. We want you to perform the following computations. Here's the first one. What is 75% of $30. John?
21.
Down to St. Pat's? John Momot?
$25.
It is $22.50. To the third decimal, what is the square root of 6? John Momot?
2.75.
Down to St. Pat's? The answer we're looking for, 2.449. And what is 33 squared? Jonathan.
669.
Incorrect. Out of St. Pat's. John.
9,009.
It is 1,089. All right, let's go to a team question. Players worth 35 points. Scramble for the first five. Batoche was established as headquarters for Louis Riel and the Métis for which specific region? John.
The 1885 Rebellion, Saskatchewan.
That's good. We'll take that for 5 points. And the rest of this team questions, all of which deal with that rebellion. In what year did the hostilities first break out?
1885.
For 10 points. Now, who led the Canadian forces against Riel?
Middleton.
John, Selkirk. I'm sorry, this is a St. Pat's question. We can't take that. We'll go back down to John Momot.
Middleton.
Middleton is correct. And after his capture, Riel was tried in which city?
Ottawa?
It's incorrect. No, it was in Regina. All right, we'll open it up now to both teams. This is a geography question worth 40 points. We want you to identify the following countries which begin with the letter S. Here's the first one. What country has an area of 582 square kilometers and is located off the tip of, John?
San Marino.
I'll finish it for Fort William Collegiate. Off the tip of the Malayan Peninsula in Southeast Asia.
John? Sri Lanka.
It's Singapore. What country has an area of just under 200,000 square kilometers and is located at the western extreme of Africa?
Saudi Danny? Arabia.
It's incorrect. Fort William Collegiate. Jonathan.
Sierra Leone.
It is Senegal. What country has an area of 62.4 square kilometers? John.
San Marino.
San Marino is good for 10. And which country occupies most of the Arabian Peninsula in the Middle East? Jonathan.
Saudi Arabia.
That's good for Chad as well. Open question now, worth 30 points on famous people of the past. Who was Aristotle's tutor in philosophy, Dave?
Plato.
It was Plato. He created a David before Michelangelo. John.
I don't know.
I'll finish it before William Collegiate. Dave?
Da Vinci.
It was Donatello. What Greek philosopher was the first to discover the true cause of the sun's eclipses?
Archimedes.
That's incorrect. Fort William Collegiate? It was? Tim.
Socrates.
It was Anaxagoras. All right, team question worth 35 points. Once again, we'll scramble for the first five. Yoko, Riding Mountain, and Wood Buffalo are all examples of what?
National parks.
National parks is right, and that opens up the rest of this team question for St. Pat's. The remaining all deal with other Canadian national parks. What is Canada's oldest national park?
Banff.
It is Banff. What national park contains the largest and most accessible ice field, namely the Columbia Ice Field?
Glacier National Park?
Again?
Glacier?
It is Jasper. And what national park has Newfoundland's second highest mountain, spectacular fjords, and the Long Range Mountains?
Cape Point.
It is Gros Morne. All right, we'll open things up to both teams now. 30-point question on biology. What is the single most abundant molecule in all, John?
Carbon.
In all living things, Fort William Collegiate? Tim?
H2O, water.
Water is correct. Water is able to serve as the medium of transport of many materials because of what property?
Dave? It's the universal solvent.
That's correct as well. And what is the zone of underground water called? Tim?
The water table.
Down to St. Pat's? Paul.
Aqueous zone?
It is the aquifer zone. Open question now worth 30 points on current events. 32 months after the Challenger disaster, the Space Shuttle Discovery was launched late in 1988. It was on a mission STS-26. In the lingo of NASA, what does STS mean, John?
The 26th mission since the start.
Up to Fort William Collegiate, Jonathan.
It's a spy satellite missile.
No, STS means Space Transportation System. Listen to the questions again, players. Now, for several days before liftoff, all systems are thoroughly checked and monitored. About 2 hours prior to takeoff, the crew enters the orbiter and checks communications with launch control at Kennedy Space Center and mission control at what space center in what other city, Dave?
Cape Canaveral.
That's incorrect. St. Pat's, John?
Houston.
Houston, yes, we can take that. The Johnson Space Center. Yes. And 31 seconds before liftoff, control of the launch switches to five computers on board Discovery from a computer system known as GLS. What's the full name of that system? Dave?
Ground Launch System.
I'm sorry, can we take that?
No.
I'm sorry, we can't take that. St. Pat's? It's Ground Launch Sequencer. All right, let's go to some general questions, players. Appian refers to what? Tim?
Birds.
Down to St. Pat's? It refers to
horses?
To bees. What pop group recorded the album Small World? Jonathan. Down to St. Pat's.
Huey Lewis?
Huey Lewis and the News is right. The words E Pluribus Unum are found on what country's coins, Jonathan?
United States.
That's right as well. And what was created, or erected rather, on April 1st of 1734 at Fort Louisbourg? John.
A French flag.
Up to Fort William Collegiate?
The British flag.
It was a lighthouse. And we'll check our score, 225 for St. Pat's to 50 for Fort William Collegiate. Of course, they started with that 105-point lead. We're going to confirm those figures, and we'll be back with more here on our championship final, Reach for the Top, in just a moment. Stay with us.
All students on Reach for the Top receive cassette tapes, courtesy of CBS Records, MCA Records, and 580 CKPR. Teams entering the playoffs also get books provided by the Albert Britnell Bookstore, Toronto. Our way of saying thank you for their appearance on Reach for the Top. Today's two teams are in championship round competition to decide the Thunder Bay champion of Reach for the Top. There were nine high schools at the start of the season, with the top six entering the playoffs. Last year, the winning team was from Fort William Collegiate Institute. And now, back to Barry Third.
And can FWCI repeat this year? Well, a rather commanding lead for St. Pat's at this point, and we'll find out whether Fort William Collegiate can get back into things in just a moment. However, before we get back to the action, we would like to take an opportunity to find out about the coaches of our two championship teams. And for an explanation of who their coaches are and how they've helped them out, let's go to our players. Tim Shadow, tell us about your coach, please.
Our coach is Ms. Kleinendorst, and she teaches history, and our manager is Ms. Goodman, and she does art.
Okay, and Danny Piccolo from St. Pat's. Danny, your coach.
Our coach is Mr. Izak, and he teaches math and sciences.
And once again, we'd like to express our thanks to those people for their efforts on behalf of Reach for the Top. All right, players, let's get right back to the action now. Please stand by your buzzers. Once again, some general questions for you. Dots and Taps was the first magazine published, Paul.
New York City.
Finish it for Fort William Collegiate, Tim?
In Braille.
First Braille magazine, good for 10. In what sport is the Waterloo Cup a coveted trophy? John.
Horse racing.
Up to Fort William Collegiate, Tim?
Cricket.
In dog racing, what classical composer wrote 104 symphonies, John?
Haydn.
That's good for 10. And what Spanish nobleman founded the Society of Jesus? John.
Ignatius, St. Ignatius.
Up to Fort William Collegiate, Tim?
Francisco.
It was Loyola. What was the earlier name of Botswana? Jonathan.
Something land.
Up down to St. Pat's? It was Beshwana land. 20-point open question now on classical music. We'll listen for that musical offering and wait for the clue if you wish. Can we hear the first one, please? John Ma.
The Marseillaise?
No, and here's the clue for St. Pat's. Edward Elgar wrote this famous march. What's its title? John?
Pomp and Circumstance.
Pomp and Circumstance, good for 10. Now let's go to the second one. John Ma.
Mendelssohn, Wedding March.
Wedding March, yes, good for 10 points there. 30-point open audio question once again on musical hits of your era, I'm sure, fellas, the 1950s. We want you to identify the vocal soloists or groups on each of the next three selections. Here's the first one.
Richie Valens.
Jonathan. Richie Valens, good. La Bamba, here's the second one for you now. John.
Jerry Lee Lewis.
That's incorrect, gotta say that.
Little Richard.
It was Little Richard with Good Golly Miss Molly. Okay, let's go to the final one. Here we are.
They ask me how I knew.
And the group, Jonathan.
Fabian.
Gotta say Pats, John.
Buddy Holly.
It's the Platters with Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. All right, let's go to our assigned questions now, players. And all of these will deal with Canadian authors. I'll give you the title of a well-named, known Canadian book. You tell me who the author was. We'll start with Tim Shano from Fort William Collegiate. Tim, The Edible Woman.
Margaret Lawrence.
That's incorrect. Down to Danny Piccolo.
I have no idea.
It was Margaret Atwood. Up to John Ma again now. John, The National Dream.
Pierre Burton.
That's good for 10. Who has seen the wind, Dave?
Margaret Lawrence.
Down to Paul Ross.
Mitchell.
It was W.O. Mitchell. And finally to Jonathan Wilson, Never Cry Wolf.
Oh, no idea.
Down to Mark Tilbury.
Farley Mowat.
Farley Mowat. Good for 10 points there. Let's go to St. Pat's and their half of this assigned question. The Manticore, Danny.
Margaret Lawrence.
Up to Tim Shano.
Stephen Leacock.
It was Robertson Davies. The Stone Angel, John.
Margaret Lawrence.
Margaret Lawrence, that's correct. And Joshua Then and Now, Paul.
Margaret Atwood.
Up to Dave Harrison. Dave?
Mitchell, I don't know.
It was written by Mordecai Rickler. Finally, Mark Tilbury, The Canadian Establishment.
I don't know.
Up to Jonathan Wilson.
Hugh McLennan.
Peter C. Newman. All right, players, let's go to a Who Am I question now worth 40 points. Here's the first clue. I was born in Ontario, but my family moved to the prairies when I was 8. I attended the University of Saskatchewan and emerged with a law degree and was called to the bar in John.
Diefenbaker?
Diefenbaker. Very good, John, for 40 points. All right, let's go to a 10-point special question. There are 5 so-called American Gulf states, the ones bordering on the Gulf of Mexico. Jonathan.
Florida, Mississippi, Alabama, Louisiana, and Texas.
That's good for 10 points. Very well done, Jonathan. Team question now. We're 35. We're going to scramble for the first 5 once again. Set in Dublin, what book by James Joyce is modeled on Homer's Odyssey? John.
Ulysses.
Ulysses. Good for 5 points. And the rest of this team question, all of which deal with Ulysses. The young protagonist of the novel is called Stephen. His surname, although with a different spelling, is the name of a hero from Greek mythology who fashioned wings for himself and his son to escape Crete.
Daedalus.
Who is he?
Daedalus.
That's good for 10. Now, Stephen Daedalus was first introduced in another Joyce novel called what? It was called Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man. Joyce's inward-turned personality helped him to master the inner monologue which forms the basis of Ulysses. He thus inaugurated which avant-garde phase of the 20th century novel?
Impressionism.
The answer, stream of consciousness. All right, let's go to a video question now on British art this time, players. Again, we invite you to watch your monitor and wait for the clue. Can we see the first one, please? Now, who was the 19th century artist, John?
Oh, no.
Finish it before William Collegiate, an early leader in the Romantic movement who painted this work.
No.
WCI?
London?
It was J.M. Turner. And here's our second one now, players. This painting, John.
Gainsborough.
I'll finish it before William Collegiate. This painting by Richard Dighton depicts the arbiter of British and continental clothing style for men during the early 19th century. Who sat for the portrait?
Nelson.
He was for William Collegiate. John.
Nelson.
It was Beau Brummel. Now, the first two decades of the 19th century in Britain were known as the Regency period, after the Prince Regent, who was the son of which king? John.
George III.
George III is right. And finally, let's go to our third painting. The Prince Regent had this exotic pavilion built as his principal, John.
The Taj Mahal.
I'll finish it for St. Pat's as his principal resident by architect John Nash. In what English city, John?
Bristol.
In Brighton. Brighton. Open question now, worth 30 points on political firsts, players. From 1946 to 1952, who served as the first Secretary General of the UN? Dave.
Lee.
Lee is correct for 10 points. David Ben-Gurion, born David Green in 1886. Dave?
The first Prime Minister of Israel.
That's good for 10 as well. Who in 1949 became the first President of Indonesia? Jonathan. Down to St. Pat's. Answer we're looking for? Sukarno. Open question now worth 30 points on theater. Name the Shakespearean play in which all of the characters are trapped on an island by a magician. John.
Tempest.
Tempest is right. In what Shakespearean play is one of the characters turned into a donkey? John.
Midsummer's Night Dream.
Good for 10 there. What month is bad news for Julius Caesar? Danny?
March.
March. The Ides of March. All right, open question worth 30 points on Canadiana. The following all deal with halls of fame in this country. Established in 1955, which city is home to Canada's Sports Hall of Fame? Jonathan.
Toronto.
That's good for 10. Which city opened the Canadian Lacrosse Hall of Fame in 1965? John?
Brantford.
Down to St. Pat's. John?
Saskatoon.
It was New Westminster. And established in 1972, which city is home to the Canadian Football League Hall of Fame? John?
Ottawa.
Up to Fort William Collegiate. City we're looking for, Tim?
Edmonton.
It is Hamilton. Open question now, we're 30 points on space. What does the acronym NASA stand for, John?
National Aeronautic...
Up to Fort William Collegiate, John.
National Aeronautic Space Agency.
Space Administration was what we were looking for, players. Command and service are two of the three modules of the Apollo spacecraft. Name the third. Jonathan.
The Eagle.
Down to St. Pat's, Paul.
Lunar Module.
Lunar Module is right. And name the first unmanned space shuttle. It was... John.
Vostok.
No. Up to Fort William Collegiate. John.
Telstar.
The Enterprise. Open question now worth 30 points on national flags. Which Asian country has a national flag that is not rectangular? John.
The Philippines.
Down to St. Pat's. John.
Nepal.
Nepal is correct. Somalia's flag consists of a white shape on a blue background. What is that white shape? John.
A sun.
Incorrect. Fort William Collegiate. Tim.
A crescent.
It is a star. There are three colors on the flag of Botswana. They are blue, white, and what other color, John?
Green.
Incorrect. St. Pat's. John.
Yellow.
It is black. Now, open question worth 30 points on Canadiana, players. What do the initials PSAC stand for? Or PSAC, as it's better known. It is the Public Service Alliance of Canada. What was Brian Mulroney's academic training before going into politics?
Lawyer.
Lawyer.
Lawyer, that is correct. Okay, George VI was the first what to visit Canada?
King of England.
The first? First reigning monarch, that is correct. All right, general questions for you now. Name the receptacle for holding baptismal water. Tim.
A font.
Font is right. What does the abbreviation deli stand for? Jonathan.
Delicatessen.
That's good as well. What is a shekel? John.
It's a currency?
Yes, we'll take that, of Israel specifically. In which body of water is the Isle of Man found? Jonathan?
The Sea of...
Down to St. Pat's? John?
Irish Sea.
Irish Sea is right. And what is the name of the comic feline created by Jim Davis? Danny?
Garfield.
Garfield is right. All right, who wrote How to Win Friends and Influence People, Tim? Or John, rather?
Dale Carnegie.
Carnegie is right. Carol and The first and Carol the second were kings of which country?
Romania.
Romania is right. What number does the Roman numeral L represent, John?
50.
That's right as well. And which city hosted the 1984 Winter Olympics? Jonathan.
Sarajevo.
That's good for 10. In which sport is a hog line found? Tim?
Curling.
That's good for 10 as well. Now, open question worth 40 points on explorers. I'll give you an explorer, and you tell me what nationality he is. The first to reach the South Pole, Roland Amundsen. Paul?
English.
He is?
Norwegian.
Norwegian, that's right. Okay, leader of several Antarctic expeditions, Sir Ernest John.
American.
I'll finish it. Sir Ernest Shackleton, Fort William Collegiate.
British.
He is Irish. Discoverer of the North Pole, Robert Perry. Jonathan.
American.
He is American. And Arctic explorer, Wilhelm Muir Stephenson. John Momot. I'm sorry, we can't accept that. Time running out. Let's go to our snappers now. In what California city would I find the Presidio? John.
Los Angeles.
Incorrect.
San Francisco.
It is San Francisco. What do infrared, ultraviolet, and gamma rays...
Forms of radiation.
I'll finish up Fort William Collegiate have in common, Tim.
They're light.
They are invisible. What former president apologized to South Korea for the scandal of his 8-year rule? Jonathan.
Eisenhower.
Down to St. Pat's.
Kim Il-sung.
Again?
Kim Il-sung.
It was Chengdu Wan. If bovine means pertaining to cattle or oxen, what does ovine refer to? John.
Chickens.
Down to St. Pat's. John.
Egg layers.
To sheep. In what country would I find the Nagorno Crater? John.
Australia.
Up to Fort William Collegiate?
The USSR.
In Kenya. Who took first place in the Reykjavik World Cup chess tournament in 1988?
Paul. Russia.
Up to Fort William?
Kasparov.
Jonathan. Kasparov is right. What is the highest mountain in New Zealand? Jonathan.
Wellington.
Down to Fort William?
Mount Cook.
Mount Cook, that's right, John. And 95% of what Canadian football club was sold in November of 1988?
Hamilton Tiger Cats.
Down to St. Pat's, Jonathan?
Ottawa.
It was the Toronto Argonauts. The Toronto Argonaut Football Club started out in what sport? John?
Lacrosse.
Up to Fort William Collegiate, John?
Soccer.
Rowing. And in what stadium was the 1988 Grey Cup played, John?
Ottawa.
Sorry, we can't accept that. Fort William Collegiate?
Taylor Fielder.
It was Lansdowne Park in Ottawa. What novelist and playwright was the winner of the 1988 Canada Council Molson Prize in the Arts?
Margaret Lawrence.
Down to St. Pat's.
Margaret Atwood.
It was Robertson Davies. In what city did the 1988 U.S. Figure Skating Championships take place? John.
Milwaukee.
Up to Fort William. Jonathan.
Lake Placid.
It was in Baltimore. In ancient tradition, what Greek island was the birthplace of the twin gods Apollo and Artemis? Dave?
Minos.
Down to St. Pat's, John.
Crete.
It was in Delos. Cincinnati in the U.S. is located on what river, John?
The Ohio River.
Ohio River is right. What is ski jumper Eddie the Eagle's real last name, John?
Edward.
It is Edwards. A little bit late on that one, though, but not much difference as St. Pat's hangs on for a 450 to 285 win over Fort William Collegiate and the championship this season here on Reach for the Top. We're going to confirm those figures and return in just a moment. Stay with us.
Reach for the Top champions will receive first-year awards from Lakehead University, and second-place finishers receive book prizes. At Lakehead University, small classes are promoted, and yet the campus is spacious, the pace relaxed, and academic excellence remains at the heart of the curriculum. Degrees are granted in the faculties of arts and sciences and professional studies. Lakehead University also offers diploma programs in engineering and forestry, all of which lead to degree studies. Lakehead University, an experience in excellence. And now, back to Barry Third and today's winning team.
Well, a slight alteration in our score, but not one that has any impact on the final decision, with St. Patrick's High School defeating Fort William Collegiate 425 to 285 in our two-game total point championship series. And our new champions here for the 88-89 season on Reach for the Top are Danny Piccolo, John Momot, Paul Ross, and Mark Tilbury of St. Patrick's High School. Our congratulations to them. Our thanks to Fort William Collegiate for a fine game. And a reminder that Reach for the Top will return next week with our All-Star Special. Please be with us then. Bye for now.
Reach for the Top is presented by CKPR-TV and Stewart Productions in cooperation with the high schools of Thunder Bay. Be with us next week as the Thunder Bay News Hounds once again take on the 1989 Student All-Stars in Challenge 2, a season-ending special on Reach for the Top. and today's winning team.
Well, FWCI just a little too quick on the buzzer for Westgate today as they roll up a 470 to 235 victory. We want to pass along our congratulations to Tim Sano, John Ma, Dave Harishan, and Jonathan Wilson. And our thanks to Westgate Collegiate for a fine game. Our thanks to you as well. And we invite you to join us once again in a week's time when we return with more playoff action here on Reach for the Top.
Reach for the Top is presented by CKPR-TV and Stewart Productions in cooperation with the high schools of Thunder Bay. Be with us next week when two more teams compete in the championship playoffs of Reach for the Top.